I'm out here on my bike ride. Pretty windy today. I'm hoping I can find a good quiet spot in the woods. Got my new to me SVEA 123R, a white gas stove. Previous owner tells me he bought it brand new 45 years ago. I lit it up once, right when it arrived the other day. It's pretty new to me. I watched a few videos, seeing how it works. I'm gonna attempt to show you how it works. I'm a few miles from my house. Just a short little bike outing today. Gorgeous. Gorgeous day. It's probably mid-50s today. Nice, cool fall day. Middle October. Guess I'll show you what I'm seeing. Check out this spot over here. I'm thinking it's gonna be too windy over here, but this is a pretty nice outlook. Turn around here. Coming off the lake. This won't be our spot. I thought I'd start off by giving you a little look at my bike. It's a surly long haul trucker. It's got a couple things on it. Love it. I had it for quite a few years now. A few different saddles. Currently using the Brooks B17 Flyer. I'm loving it. It's great. I got this Sackville saddle sack. I bought it from a buddy, but they're made by Rivendell Cycles. It is fantastic for bike packing or just doing this kind of stuff, day outings. You fit a ridiculous amount of things in there. I'll explain some of what I got once I get set up a little better. I guess I'll work on getting this stuff out and I'll get back with you. Got this table. It's probably eBay, I think. It was pretty inexpensive, but it's really nice for bar camping or this sort of a thing. I wouldn't use it for backpacking, but I mean, it doesn't weigh much, but it takes up a good amount of real estate. Super simple setup. So something else I have, I think, is pretty neat. It's a ceramic mug. It's a cork. And a padded koozie on my handlebars. The koozie bar mount situation is made by Randy Joe Fab. You can find them on Instagram. I'll put a link to their website in my show notes. The mug is handmade by Casey Clark over at Great Basin Pottery. I'll include a link to him too. He makes some really awesome stuff. But I mean, it's a little heavy for camping, backpacking camping, but man, it's pretty awesome to have a nice ceramic mug with you when you're out on your bike for the day. Alright, I'll show you what I got with me here. Start off with this first. This is just a little Reflectix koozie for my pot. Keep it warm when it gets colder. This is a Timber Brother titanium 750 milliliter. Fits pretty much perfectly on this SVEA stove. You gotta put it on upside down, put the lid on here, but it still kind of works perfect. Windscreen fits pretty tight in there, so what I end up doing is pulling the stove out. Then I gotta grab the windscreen. Give it a tug. I may find something different in the future, but for now this is working pretty good. Here's that SVEA. SVEA 123R. Like I said, it's 45 years old. It could use a little bit of a clean up, but I think it's just cool looking. Kind of a piece of art. Here's the windscreen. Got your pot stands. Got your key. Let's get some water in this pot. Put about a cup and a half in there. Probably all I need some coffee. This is a white gas stove. Just pour some fuel in there. Actually looks like I got a pretty good amount in there. All
what's interesting about this stove compared to something a little more modern like a Whisper Light or even a like a Coleman white gas stove, you got this little indentation here, this little dish. You're gonna put some fuel in there to prime it. Some people put alcohol. I got the fuel here, so I'm just gonna pour some fuel in there. Try not to make a mess. So, we'll get that lit. What that's gonna do, I'm gonna spin this too long. That's gonna do, so that's gonna heat up the tank and build pressure in the tank. So instead of pumping it like you would on a Whisper Light or a Coleman stove, it's going to build its own pressure. It'll take a little bit to get heated up, but once that gets heated, I should be able to open the valve. Fuel is going to come out the jet at the top. Put the windscreen on. Flame's starting to burn out. Let's crack that. Now it's going to keep heating up, but we definitely got some pressure building. Stove's kind of like a little freight train. Oh, by the way, this is the pot that comes with it. Kind of covers up on there real nice, but it's too little to be practical for me. And you can see it's really starting to take off. Let's open that up a little bit. A really unique sound. This one. Just gotta scoop this over a little. Show you my mug here. Cheating today. Just gonna use some instant espresso. A lot of times I'll do a French press. This pot's got a French press for it. I like the AeroPress a lot too, but today we're just gonna do some Starbucks instant espresso. I actually really like it. I got a little alcohol stove in here. I usually carry around with me. It's actually a SVEA stove, if you're familiar with SVEA and his YouTube videos. A little alcohol. A little espresso can, SVEA stove. this is a Firebox Ultra Cook Kit. This is bacon. Big fan of this cook kit. Season it like cast iron. Treat it like a cast iron pan, basically. It's anodized aluminum. So seasoned it in an oven just like you would cast iron. Got a plate. Cowboy pans. Titanium fork and spoon set. It's really cool about it. So you got this little connector piece. You got yourself some tongs for your bacon. And that works great. Well, my battery died on me. So we got going on is some bacon in there. Using these titanium tongs. Then the Firebox stove pan set. Like I was saying before my battery died and my camera shut off, I decided to try this YouTube thing. I was out solo camping with my hammock hot tent and thought, man, I wish I had a camera. Give me someone to talk to, I guess. But also, just to show, I like to show what I got going on. I like to watch videos and see what other people got going on and see what works for them. So on my way home, I stopped at Goodwill and I picked up an $8 camera, just a little digital camera. And 2 days later, here we are. We're gonna try this out. I don't know if it'll be something I keep doing or not. Well, we'll see how this goes. But I guess I got a lot of gear I could share. tell you what, this is really the first time I've used this SVEA stove. And it is working awesome. I was actually surprised I could simmer it down as low as I could. I mean, you could take it right down to a little candle flame. One thing I've heard, don't leave the key in because it will get hot. I guess I got lucky. It's not too bad. Oh, that's good. Big fan of Morgan Bones pipe tobacco. Probably see me with one of these every once in a while.
As they say, now we're cooking with bacon grease. I'm really, really liking the adjustability on that stove, and just the simplicity of it, and it's little. It seems like that tank holds a ton of fuel. So we'll definitely be curious to see how that works on a winter outing, how many days it'll last, things like that.
got this GSI Outdoors folding spatula. Works pretty good. It loose fits up. Garlic salt on there. A little bit of black pepper. Ooh, a lot of bit of black pepper. That's all right. Camera keeps shutting itself off, so I don't know. Like I said, this is my first time. I don't know what I'm doing. So basically, dumped out my bacon grease. I'm gonna clean this now. I'm gonna turn my heat up. Okay, so I learned a few things. My battery kept dying. Changed them. There were some spare batteries that came with the camera. That's what you get when you get it from Goodwill. I've learned a couple things. Get some new batteries. Make sure they're good and charged. I don't know what all I got in the video. Battery kept dying. Camera kept turning off. I went over. I made bacon. I made eggs. I went over cleaning my pan, just like you would a cast iron, real easy, awesome for in the woods. Of course, my camera was off when I was done, so I don't know what all I got, but I'm gonna eat my breakfast, and maybe I'll touch base with you again when I'm done. there's really nothing like eating delicious breakfast in the woods, sitting in your hammock. Oh yeah. Gorgeous day out here. Oh, warmed up to about 60 now when I looked at my thermometer a little bit ago. Just an awesome fall day. I hope if nothing else, anybody who watches this is inspired to maybe do this kind of thing. It may seem silly to some people going out in the woods on your bike and making food, but man, it's just escape from reality. I mean, if you can't get out on a whole camping trip, I mean, it doesn't have to be. Walk on your local trail, by a nearby lake, in a park, whatever, wherever you live, and just make some coffee. It doesn't take much. It's a lot better than sitting in front of your TV all day. Just saying. But I mean, I guess if that's what you want to do is sit in front of your TV all day and watch me do it, you can do that too. Good stuff. So, against popular opinion, I am laying in, you know, double nest hammock, which pretty much the gateway drug to hammock. Like most people, this was my first hammock. I bought it. Thirteen years ago, and I've camped in it for just as long. It is a 9-foot 4-inch hammock versus the more popular 11-foot hammock for camping. And it's been just fine. That being said, I did order myself a Warbonnet Eldorado. The 0° Wookiee underquilt. And that is gonna be sweet. It's gonna be so sweet. It's actually supposed to be delivered tomorrow, but I'll be back at work. So look forward to a review video of that, that's for sure. Look forward to that. I recently picked up a Hennessy Hammock Deluxe Explorer. My fiance claimed that just as soon as she laid down in it. Man, this is nice. Well, probably gonna lay here for another hour or so. And then maybe I'll look into buying some new batteries for my camera. I just want to thank anybody who actually watched this video for watching it. I hope you got something out of it. I learned that the SVEA stove is pretty handy, pretty nice stove. I got out, I had a good breakfast, got to enjoy a little bit of a Sunday. Thanks for watching. Until next time. Thanks.